My dad, who is watching over the internet, is going to love this one.
Oh,
talented and bearded, Mr. Rusty Siri.
Hi friends, how are you? Welcome to the living room. I know we're 10 minutes behind. Thank you so much for your patience. I'll try and talk as fast as I can. Thanks for being comfortable and accommodating some extra folks tonight so you all can see our one night on the extension of the Death of Cupid. My name is Rusty Sarah, I'm the artistic director here for those of you that I don't know. I'd like to propose a quick toast if you have a drink, if you'll join me. If you don't, you should seriously correct that in admission. It's a whiskey musical. Cheers to you for being here. Thank you so much for supporting local theater and for supporting what we do here at the Living Room. We quite literally could not do it without you. It certainly would not be as much fun. So,
cheers.
So here we are at the end of our third season, which has been an amazing ride this season. Thank you, all of you who have supported the season. You're here for the Death of Cupid. It's an original whiskey musical written and directed by Kyle Hatley. Each act is about an hour long. There is a 15-minute intermission. At that time, I would encourage you to please get a drink or get rid of a drink on the mezzanine and then return to your seat. I have to tell you guys, I'm a little nervous giving this curtain speech right now for the first time in my life because this show, as some of you may know, is live streaming tonight. Hi, everybody. We've got people watching this performance in New York, Chicago, L.A., Okoboji, Australia, St. Louis, Egypt, U.K., everywhere. So enjoy, everyone. Enjoy. Welcome to the living room. What else? Just a quick little audience interaction, guys. We're going to play a little game I like to call Don't Ruin the Show. The rules are simple. It's just if you have a cell phone or anything else that makes noise. I don't know what that might be. Maybe I don't want to know. But if you could do all of you can to silence those things. This is a very intimate space. The actors will be surrounding you. And coming from every aisle, every entrance, a cell phone is very distracting to the story that we're telling, even if it vibrates loud, the cell phone, that it is distracting. So thank you for doing that. If you like the show tonight, I would normally say tell your friends to come back and see it, but this is the last shot, so thanks for being here. But if you're not on our mailing list that's over there by the bar, I would encourage you to sign up for that. We'll be announcing our fourth season here very quickly in the next week or so. I'll be blasting an email to everyone on our mailing list with a special deal for just those people to buy a season pass for next season, so do that. There's also a bucket over there, you guys, that says that. But says, please help keep the living room living. If you have 5 cents, 15 cents, a dollar, $5, $25,000, want to drop it in there, we would be eternally grateful. We are a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so any generous donation that you might be willing to make can be tax deductible. And it's greatly, greatly appreciated. There's so many wonderful things we can do with even $5, truly, and we will love you for it. The role of Hercules tonight, in case any of you were wondering, it's been a cameo performance every night for this run, which I've got to say has been a lot of fun. Tonight it is the one and only Mr. Matt Rapport. let's give it up one more time for Apollo and the Slow Death Band. If you have drinks, I would encourage you, unless you like them to be a little gritty, to keep them off the floor. You may have noticed we got a little bit of sand in the show. Sit back and enjoy the Death of Cupid by Kyle Hatley.
In the beginning, there
heard on his voice. And Zara changed everything.
My love.
came home and got busy.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I gotta go. I'll write you. I love you. Bye.
Stop it! feel the harsh touch of a warrior's rough hands. And there's no going back to the way things used to be.
Wait! Stop!
Don't go.
Wait! Stop!
Why won't you look at me? What happened to you?
I said I ain't gonna tell nobody. Seven seas under
me. Please.
Come back.
And like that? They're gone. And like that? Oh, women. Don't you weep. Before they received the black letter, telling them how bravely their husbands had fought, how bravely they had died. The goddess Athena, having witnessed the desperate efforts of the Athenian wives, was appalled. Mother!
Baga! I'm busy!
Hera!
Talk. Oh, that bard, handsome. To be continued.
What is it, Athena? The soldiers returned home on shore leave today.
Adorable!
Their wives are becoming a problem for my war.
Mercury!
I'd like a mimosa, dear.
Forgive me, Athena, but if I'm to start my morning with your whining, I might as well start it with a drink. Go on.
We're losing their pride.
Whose pride?
The women of Athens. They're beginning to reject my war.
Well, you could do what your father does and just kill them.
I shouldn't have to interfere. They should respect their creators.
Well, honey, that's why we have Cupid, isn't it? Just have him, you know, shoot a few arrows into these women and voila, problem solved.
No, it's not that simple.
Of course it is.
Something is stirring in these women. Their men, on the other hand, are fighting, proving themselves to be true Athenians.
Oh, yes. Brave little soldier boys, all grown up to become what?
Men.
They're ghosts, darling, all of them.
How dare you speak of them as ghosts?
Your war will call them ghosts.
My war is necessary for peace.
Necessary for peace?
That's a good one.
Should never have come to you for help.
You know, for an omnipotent being, Athena, you are so naive.
These women are a disgrace to Athens, and they should all be punished severely. But I shouldn't have to interfere. Cupid shouldn't have to regulate our reign. I shouldn't have to strike down those that sin against me. I don't understand the human being, Hera. But I need to.
You are just like your father. All ego and no cause. It's no wonder you were born out of his head.
I knew it was a mistake.
See that bird? It's been flying for days without rest or water or nourishment. The bird is a different beast from the human. Do you know why?
No.
It is not afraid. It does not complain. It just moves until it finds a place to land. Only then does it feed and water itself.
Suppose it never finds a place to land.
It dies, my dear. But it dies without ever having felt sorry for itself. It does not rationalize, so it cannot deduce that it is dying, or that it can die at all. It merely lives to live. The human being lives to die. It lives in fear and respect of death. Mercury!
There's one of them now. Lysistrata. What is she doing?
She's waiting.
For what?
For his touch.
But what is his touch if nothing more than a touch?
Oh, my dear girl, his touch is a promise. A promise of love.
How long will she wait?
As long as it takes.
All new Athenian widows. Your husband is dead. He fought like a true Athenian. Be proud.
And now she will never know his touch again.
Athena!
She's praying to me.
Athena!
Oh, no, she's not.
Athena!
The Athenian widow experiences the following initial gut reactions. The first is revenge.
I am going to kill your whore!
Bitch!
Be still, Athena!
This is what I'm talking about!
You said you wanted to understand the human being, so lower your weapon and listen.
You've got nothing to say to that? Nothing?
The second reaction is despair.
Kill me. Nothing. Please! Isn't that what you do to those who scorn you? Please! Please, go ahead. Kill me. Kill me.
The third reaction, the most dangerous and the most common, is resignation. But something different is stirring inside of Lysistrata. Something darker.
There is a bomb in Gilead.
And it connected with the universe.
To make the wounded whole.
What is she doing? You make toys of my problems.
Your tyranny has gone on long enough.
And what of your tyranny, Athena? Even now, after witnessing that girl's pain, you still have no idea what it means to be human? My dear girl, they are looking for salvation.
From what?
From fate. Oh, you're wrong. Am I? Face it. Athena, dear, we are a dying breed. Our creations are taking responsibility for themselves. Or trying to, anyway. And it is for this reason I have taken up the hooch.
So what can I do?
Well, first, you should understand your subjects.
How do I do that?
You can start by following her.
Mother!
Oh, God.
Mother!
Athena, darling, would you like a drink? Your sister's coming. Trust me, you'll need one.
Who the hell is this Lissa Strada? What the hell is this I hear about a sex strike?
Hello, Aphrodite!
My, aren't you looking radiant this morning?
Who is she?
She's my responsibility.
Kill her, please, now, please! Take her, your spear and do whatever it is you're doing and take her life. No, in fact, take her soul and divide it up and put it all over the world so she'll never be put back together again. No, in fact, take her soul and rip it into 1,000 pieces. And oh my God, she's pretty. Look at that. On second thought, you better give some of her soul to me. What? Okay, yes, fine, I'm getting wrinkles. You're not getting any less, more immortal, Hera, bitch.
I think you look nice, Mom.
Thank you, Cupid. All right, let's make this quick. I got a thing at 3:10.
Sorry, girls. Liz Estrada lives.
What? Mother?
I've decided to give the little girl a chance.
This is bullshit. Cupid, fix it.
Oh, Mom.
Arrows, don't even think about it. Aphrodite, if you touch that girl down there, the consequences will be severe.
You can't do this to me! Or Athena!
You're not gonna let her get away with this, are you? I don't have a choice.
What the hell is going on?
Okay, fine. I'm telling Daddy. He's in his sunroom! But last time I checked, I still wear the pants in this family, so you might want to think twice about plotting him against me. Besides, he'll say no, and you know it.
Is there anything I can do to reverse your decision?
Actually, now.
Bitch!
Aphrodite, do not touch that woman.
Cupid.
I'll take that as a yes!
Oh! And for the record, Grandma, it's Cupid, not Eros. How many times do I have to tell you I go by my Roman name now? Why can't anybody just accept that? You don't seem to have any problems calling Hermes Mercury, for God's sake, and he's just a fucking messenger!
Cupid!
I'm coming! Shit, piss, fuck, titty, cock, sucker, motherfucker!
Now, on that one. Athena, darling, keep an eye on our girl. If I know Aphrodite, she'll do anything to stop her.
Hera! You coming back to bed? Athena. This is awkward.
I'll be right there, hot stuff.
We're running a little low on ambrosia.
I'll have Mercury pick some up.
okay. Athena! Catch you later.
We're a dying breed. All right, muscle man, round two!
Good morning, Apollo.
Did a fight with Mom?
This woman is planning a sex strike in protest of our war.
Who is she?
A new kind of soldier.
Athena's rage is suppressed only by her curiosity. Apollo, to his surprise, saw something new. Dangerous in his sister's eyes. Respect. For a rebellious mortal.
Abominably, you're attempting to kill sex. Have you lost your mind? It's a disgrace to my mother.
If that's my only offense, then go ahead. Kill me.
Oh, I can't kill you. Yet. I can only make you love or hate.
And what will you make me do?
Love or hate?
You will love your country.
And you will hate your enemy. And life will remain prolific.
You're taking away my free will.
A casualty of fate, my dear. Stay still.
My God, you're nothing more than a hitman.
In diapers.
You know what? The diapers are a mere simplification to accommodate my very busy schedule. This wardrobe choice is perfectly suited to my vocation. Stop it! Stop laughing! That's it!
Athena, you lousy bitch! Whose team are you on?
With this one, you little winged freak. Hera's rules.
Fuck. Mom's gonna be so mad at me. Shit, balls, monkey, fuck ass, cock sucking man!
Yeah, go change your diaper, you fucking maniac!
So I have their attention.
Let him go. I'd be a better Athenian. a better woman, a better wife. I'd sacrifice whatever it takes. Anything.
I'd take a big knife and I'd cut myself right down the middle and I'd give him half of me. But only half, because obviously I'd need the other half.
I have a plan that will bring your husband home from war and keep him home. But before I tell you, I need you to promise me your commitment. Then what?
Oh shit!
Phase one is already a
did the whole time.
No!
No, Linnaia, you've got to tease your man.
Yeah, we'll just give it all away for him to see.
Make him work for it.
Yeah!
Yeah.
It is your individual choice that will keep our defense strong. Know that. Understand that. If one of us breaks, we all break. Choice is power. Know that. Understand that. And no matter what, keep your eyes on the prize. Do you understand?
Yes!
Now let's get to the Acropolis and join our fellow warriors in the fight. No!
The letter she sent to the women of Athens and Sparta, the letter that would transform enemies into allies, our hero wrote, how will we end? Will we be marked and speechless? Or will we realize our potential before all of this? Before a voice cries out from the bottom of the Aegean Sea, it is done. People did not like it here.
Thank you for saving me from this, whoever you are. But we can do this on our own.
And so began Lysistrata's stand against a man's will.
You're angry.
I'm impressed.
Where are you going?
See how she holds up against the men.
Meanwhile, on Mount Olympus.
What do you mean Athena interfered? Did you miss? Please tell me you didn't miss.
I thought I was alone, but Athena was obviously protecting her.
Did I miss? I never miss. Fuck.
Great.
Great.
Fuck. How am I supposed to get this Lysistrata?
Well, there are other ways, Mother.
Like what, you little smartass?
You could control those around Lysistrata.
I have a brilliant idea. I could control those around Lysistrata.
Oh my god, what a brilliant idea. I can't believe you thought of it all on your own.
Wow!
Hera said nothing about regulating those that support Lysistrata. Follow her followers, and when they least expect it, shoot them down. Make them hate their choice to support the little activist, and make them yearn for their husband's hot, throbbing.
I'm on it.
They're enormous popsicles. They're gigantic, juicy junk.
Shit, Mom.
Cupid, wait! They're purple-headed
wolves. In the days that followed, all of Athens have come to know that it's women that are taking control of the crops. Funding, the council magistrate can understand those obedient men who have stayed behind. Those unfit to fight.
On orders from the magistrate! We back the treasury! Hurry up, minister, make him wait!
Fire!
for this break.
He's got a point, sir! Both are way on our hammer! Please!
With all your crying and moaning, you men make me sick! If age slows your advance on a woman, advance with your prick. Join me!
Will fail. Bring me
who's responsible for this? Who is responsible for this? Dyck, I hate repeating myself.
I hate it for you, sir.
Don't make me do it again.
Yes, sir. Who is responsible for this?
That would be me, sir.
And what is your name?
Lysistrata.
Speak up.
Lysistrata.
Don't make him repeat himself. He hates repeating himself.
Dyck.
Yes, sir.
Mine.
Sorry, sir.
Playtime is over, sweetheart. Men, secure the Acropolis.
No, sir. I'm afraid playtime has just begun.
Darling, I'm a reasonable man, but this fucking heat makes my privates itch. Dyck, do I like it when my privates itch? Dyck!
Oh, did you mean me, sir? No, sir, you do not like it when your private's itch, sir!
Takes away my patience. Isn't that right, Dyck?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
The point is, Lysistrata, I get violent when I get impatient. And when I get violent, people lose their ability to walk, or talk, or live. You get my point?
I'm afraid I don't. Magistrate, could you repeat yourself?
Sir, breathe it out. Just breathe it out.
Good, sir. That's very good, sir.
You, Lysistrata, and these women, all Athenian women, are traitors to your country.
I like to think of us as patriots.
Did you hear that? Oh, no, they're patriots. National heroes they are. These women of Athens, who take control of the treasury, call themselves patriots.
Oh, yes.
Sounds like a blind patriot to me.
More so than you.
When you interfere with a man's business, little girl, you better be prepared to be treated as one. How's that, field trainer? Dyck, how am I doing?
Swimmingly, they're officially appalled.
You are the traitor! You and all the politicos that fund, plot, and perpetuate this fucking war! In this pathetic way of life! And we, women, are goddamn sick of it!
Do you have any idea of what you've done? You have cut off Athens' only security, little girl!
What I've done is cut off the dick of this war! And to show you we mean business, we're cutting off your sex supply as well! Guess you'll have to turn to imports now! Oh, wait. What imports? That's right. Everybody hates Athens! And after your little shindig in Sicily, why should we ever follow your lead again?
Sicily was a strategic...
Thousands died! Yes, died. Erased, eradicated, no longer around, gone!
That was a casual war, little missy. Something you women know nothing about.
Sir, we know everything about the casualty of war. Believe me, my dear council magistrate, it is you who is in over his head.
Remain calm, sir.
The last person who spoke to me in such a tone no longer wears their skin.
Remember all the letters we got about that one?
It is an honor to fight for your country.
Well played, sir.
Quiet.
Yes, sir.
As long as there is cause, there is honor.
Oh, she got you there, sir.
Will you shut up?
You know what's amazing to me? That a politician would have the audacity to ask a woman what she knows about the casualties of war. And I bet you couldn't even tell me the color of blood.
Do not question my service.
And you served where your scars.
I have my
scars. Yeah, bureaucratic scars, paper cuts.
I have been to the front line. So do not tell me what I have or have not seen.
Perhaps it would be a...
Stay out of this. Let me ask you something. Little girl, have you ever seen the face of war? Have any of you women ever seen it?
Have any of you ever seen it? No, you have not. So I'm going to say this very clearly. Your act is killing your men.
Don't say that.
Your weapons cost money, Lysistrata. Would you have your husbands fight without them?
We'd rather than not fight at all. We'd rather than be alive.
Being alive is a privilege.
No, sir, it is a goddamn
privilege. No, it is a privilege because we men fight for you, ignorant cunt. You're nothing more than terrorists. All of you.
How dare you
call us? The Spartans draw closer by the day. And your little movement here is robbing Athenian soldiers of their weapons. And it is you, Lysistrata. You who is killing them.
Enough!
We think of your husband.
My husband is dead!
Just another one of your fucking sacrifices.
Dear girl, if it is revenge you seek, I suggest you look to the north. For it was a Spartan who took your husband's life, not your government, not me, not the tens of thousands of soldiers still fighting, still dying, still suffering their own scars. Treasury, Lysistrata, and let us conquer the country that killed your soldier. Our soldier.
Don't you fucking touch me.
You're making a huge mistake, sweet pea. I mean, without the treasury, the Spartans will invade. And they will take Athens!
I can assure you that Sparta will not take Athens, nor will we take Sparta.
How can you be so sure of that?
Management!
Fucking women! You have no idea of what it takes to defend a nation. You have no idea of what it is that we men do for you.
You're right! We should...
A good Athenian woman.
The cost is a woman's loss.
Push.
A useless love.
Love lost. Good Athenian woman.
The cost is a woman's loss. Why? When I speak of love.
Love.
Athenian woman. The cost is a woman's loss.
Why?
When I speak of love.
Love. I am done playing games with you, little girl. Men, kill these women. Secure the Acropolis.
My dearest magistrate.
Kill these women.
One thing, you men.
Secure the Acropolis.
My dearest magistrate. When we fight.
That's what it takes. Money and all. We'll burn you to the ground.
Come on.
Get
out of here.
Series of choices. The women had prevailed. They had done it.
But what is done can always be undone.
How's it hanging, Athena?
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Cupid, no!
Just a little target.
Put your arrow.
down!
For what?
I am warning you!
For what?
You can't stop!
See, Harris doesn't even live in Strada alone. She didn't say anything about the friends.
Oh! Harris! Harris!
Thank you. I checked, he was in second place. He got me his birth for my birthday.
He did? Is it a coach?
Oh, yeah.
Did he get it or did he?
No.
My cousin did.
My cousin got it.
Sure, he went out and picked it out all by himself.
Does
he actually sign his name?
No.
You know, if he signed his name, that might be clutch or something.
No, I'm selling it on eBay. Yeah. 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 I went out on a day from Cheese Harmony the other day, and the guy was like telling me how to race dirt track. I was like, oh my god.
How old is he?
36, 37.
A little too late.
Well, he...
So did you name drop on him? You didn't?
Oh, he should have named him. Well, he raced dirt track for a long time. He had a long time.
But you're like, still... he must not have been very good.
But he's still talking about it.
So it's like talking about, you know, in the high school, that was pretty good.
When you do it 10 years out of high school.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, she was telling me that. Yeah, well, no, I didn't know.
I was just like, oh my god.
Dino? Well, didn't Dino call Edwards?
Yeah, if I had any interest in it whatsoever, I might have engaged Lamar.
Yeah, you know. I mean,
Carl and I are at Christmas together.
Oh, it was the best time for us.
When I was feeling in his head.
His crew chief's giving me a couple of tips. Maybe I'll have a hand to help you out. You haven't been in this plane, have
you? No. My mom has. My mom's like all through there, garages and all that other stuff. I'm like,
he's got more garage space than he's got house space.
Well, at the track.
Oh.
Yeah.
What does he do? For a living. An accountant?
I get up.
It's kind of anti dirt track racing, isn't it?
No, I don't know. I don't know.
Hey, I heard about some new deal. I guess
they're
on the regular rate. Oh, man. And so, you don't like whipping people or anything. What you do is and then they hook you up, and then like, you guys start by just texting.
I'm making a DVD for them, and I have part of the second half already on footage from yesterday, but I'm just going to
just reshoot it, and I'm just gonna do one main shot, and then I'll just have you're able to run. So yeah, definitely. Because I know how hard it is doing it. This I just have to push a button and let it go.
Yeah. character run. Because I was like, oh.
And then I was like, oh, why not?
Oh, shit, what?
Terra Quid. The passion of Cupid's love and hate courses through their veins, spreading viciously to every corner of their body, infecting them, changing them. The reaction between humans' choice and God's will makes monsters of them. Meanwhile, from Mount Olympus, the goddess of love watches in horror.
My God.
Bravo! Bravo, Aphrodite! Truly inspirational work. Really showed them.
What are you doing here, Athena? Shouldn't you be down there holding their hands?
I just thought I'd drop by to say thank you.
For what?
Oh, for setting the human being back. Another millennia? At this rate, they'll always be slaves.
It's a beautiful sight, though, isn't it? Just marvelous, really. Why'd you do it, Aphrodite?
God, you're pathetic, Athena.
Why did you do it?
Because I can't have women abstaining from sex. Sex is love, love is sex. I'm the goddess of love. Don't see me interfering with war or wisdom or your virginity. I am? No. Besides, what does it matter? We left Lysistrata alone, didn't we?
She had a chance.
She's a human being in a god's world. She never had a chance.
I'm gonna kill your son! Wanted you to know that.
Whoa, 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 whoa! This is nothing to get vindictive about. It was just a few women.
Athenian women.
So what? And besides, you can't destroy another god without daddy's permission.
I need Zeus's permission. I don't care what happens to me after I do it.
Over my dead body.
If that's what it takes, then I'll see you in hell.
We don't go to hell. Or have you been spending so much time with the humans, you're actually starting to think like one? No. No, we suffer. We suffer more than a human being could possibly imagine. We are made into warning signs for other gods who think they can do whatever they want, and I would hate to see that happen to my little sister. Look at them. Look at them! What could they possibly know about their own world?
Far too smart to need us anymore. And you're far too dumb to know it.
Oh God, are you actually buying Hera's bullshit?
They're taking responsibility for themselves.
They fear us.
They fear your son's arrows.
It's called regulation, honey.
It's called greed, Aphrodite! Has there been anything more than fucking greed? We sent Cupid down to keep them in fear and respect of us, and all they want is their freedom! They just want to live their lives!
Which we have given them.
We've also given them death.
Death defines life!
So does choice.
So what? You want us to give them their immortality?
No. I want us to give them choice by killing things.
My son, Athena.
I don't care.
Athena, Athena.
Who are we to give them everything only to regulate it?
What happened to you? You used to be the strongest of us all.
They were this close to realizing their potential, their human potential, and Cupid prevented them from seeing it, as he has always done since the beginning of time.
But he's one of us.
And what are we exactly? Huh? Animal tamers.
We are gods.
No. We are ideas. Something has to be done.
Don't you touch my son, Athena! Don't you dare!
It will fall, Aphrodite, and it will be by my hand.
Athena! Athena!
It's okay, sweetie. It's okay.
Mom. Mom's here.
She's going to kill Cupid. I'm the one who ordered the hit, not Cupid, not my little boy.
I know.
No, but I don't understand. I don't understand. They gave their hearts back to them. They wandered, they strayed, and I gave their hearts back to them.
My beautiful girl. No.
face. Corinth or in Athens.
Mother.
Made in our image. Look at them.
They may be mortal, but they deserve a chance.
And this one here, is Estrada?
Has the courage to take that chance.
They are climbing, Aphrodite. And soon we will see face to face with the humans.
No.
And then they will know fully what we have always known.
Emotion, and this is how you behave. This is how you behave! You are dust! All of you! How dare you act above what you are in you!
Miss Estrada, you think you can change the world? You think anything you do in this world can move the gods? You are nothing but a mortal. And mortals mean nothing.
Mrs. Starla, what do we do now?
We have to stop this. We can't win this.
Again, something dark is stirring inside the Starla.
But the gods are involved now.
The gods have been involved since the beginning.
But this is bigger than stopping a war. We're going after the gods, aren't we? Aren't we?
She looked around at her wounded soldiers, their bodies twitching, their breath deep, their hearts bleeding, and their potential vanishing.
So what should we do?
We stay the course.
Are you kidding me? Look at them. Look at what the gods will do to us if we continue.
Cupid's arrows are winning them by the second. And what could Lysistrata possibly do to heal them? To save them from the gods.
Lysistrata! Say something!
And she connected with the universe.
A lover's touch is good as gold. When he's home for you to hold, keep your eyes on the prize. Hold on. Save your heart, you gotta use your head. Keep your eyes.
shut!
You are enough, dear soldiers. No god can overcome the passion that you were born with. No god can exceed the power of your own heart. So do not fucking let them.
Just looking out for you.
Look out for yourself.
Blame them.
You know what's ironic about why you're here, Lesbiana Jones?
Plans are changing. What's so funny?
How do you make a god laugh?
How?
You make a plan. There's a hell of a risk when you take away fate. Allow me, please, to demonstrate. You see, a path is chosen when a choice is made. Allow me, please, to demonstrate.
Ascended from
holding the arrow that would kill fate.
She's going to do it. She's going to kill Cupid.
There must be another way. Where is Cupid now?
Hidden.
Take me to him.
Surely there was another way. Surely policy had not completely failed. For when it does, war thrives. As for the mortals, the men of Athens battle two forces now. Their women and a stirring in their pants.
This way, men!
Watchful and alert, these beastly women still stand their posts!
Word has it women all over Greece are behaving similarly from coast to coast.
It's true, the Spartans have halted their flank at sea.
But surely the magistrate wouldn't prevent our rescue of the treasury.
These are hard times in the history.
Even so, men, my cock is tempted towards peace.
Now worry not, men, the magistrate is sending just the right man to save our penises. A great man, one who will stop this female plan, the newly appointed General Synesius.
Meanwhile, in a secret location, Aphrodite kept her son hidden from Athena's hunt.
Where have you been?
Out. Mommy had some thinking to do. Did you have fun today?
What do you think? You got me locked up in this secret hiding place just because my aunt wants to kill me. Yes, Mother, I had a fantastic day. Fucking peachy!
Cupid, if I asked you to do something or asked you to stop doing something, would you obey?
Of course!
I want you to surrender your bow and arrows to me.
I'm sorry. What?
It may be the only way Athena will let this thing go.
You have got to be kidding me!
Mom, you don't answer to Athena. You answer to Hera.
Hera wants you dead!
Why?
They believe that humans should be able to choose their own passions, but in order to do that, they must kill fate.
Me. But I'm a god, Mother.
Hand over your arrows, Cupid.
Why are you doing
I'm
this?
I'm trying to save you. Hand them over, sweetie.
No!
Cupid, when Hera orders your fall, and she will, we will never see each other again. Do you understand?
What would I be without my arrows? What would I be?
You'd still be my son.
That's not good enough. What kind of a mother are you?
The kind that's trying to save her job.
You betrayed me, Mother!
Cupid, please don't do that.
And it is you who will surrender
this. This is exactly why they are trying to stop you!
I'd like to see them try!
Cupid, put your arrow down!
Fuck you, Apollo! Fuck all of you! I don't believe I belong to this family. I don't believe it! It has become a crying fucking shame!
You men! What am I gonna stop? What can I do?
There's nothing you can do. It's beyond our control.
From his mother, goddammit, there must be something I can do.
No, Daddy, listen to me. We have to get to Athena before she gets to Cupid.
And do what?
Convince her to give Cupid another chance.
She'll never agree to it.
Then we get the humans behind us to show Athena that we're behind her. If we stick together and explain it to Cupid as a family, maybe he will see. Maybe he will understand.
You don't know my son.
The gods of Olympus were learning that the nature of fate is to control us all. But those that had overcome fate's arrows were now about to overcome a different kind of shaft.
Tyranny! Tyranny! I'm home! Tyranny!
Oh, hello, Synesius. Oh, I'm sorry. General Synesius.
it is so good to see you. Baby, darling, love of my life. I'm miserable.
Oh, well, maybe I can help.
Yes, yes, you can. Only you can. I am in so much pain. If you don't quit the silly protest, sweetie, I'm afraid I could hurt myself. I mean, this is not healthy.
Well, what can I help you with?
My erection! Why do you think? From that time you don't notice it. I just need you to give me some, you know, attention.
Right here in a public square, someone might see us.
I don't care if the gods themselves are watching. Just give me some fucking...
Hey! Don't yell at me.
I am sorry. I just...
I'm blinded by desire, baby. You know?
Uh-huh.
For you? For your touch? And your soft skin? All I think about is you.
Oh.
Your soft lips. The way your hair smells.
Oh, I haven't washed it in days.
And the warmth of your tongue. Yes. And how our tongues feel together in the beds of our mouths.
Oh,
making their own kind of love.
Oh, that sounds nice.
And how it feels to finally press into you.
Oh, my.
And the way we move together.
I like moving together.
Our skin, our sweat sticking together, your body fitting with mine.
Oh, it's a good fit.
Yes.
Oh, I like a good fit.
My hands in your body as our speed gradually builds.
Faster, deeper.
Your hands on my body gripping, clawing at each other, fingernails tearing our backs. And you don't want to deny me that, do you, sweetheart? You don't want to deny yourself that, do you?
You're sweating.
Sweating for you, beautiful.
You poor baby. Let me feel your forehead.
Oh, God, baby, yes.
Oh, you are warm. Hot.
Burning up, baby.
Let me get you an aspirin or something.
No! You're the only medicine I need, Eryn.
You could be coming down with a fever. You know what you need.
Everything I need is right here. Take me right here, right now.
But I made a choice to abstain.
Yeah, but you made a choice to honor and love your husband, too, just like I love and honor you. Now kiss me!
Oh, fuck it!
Ah!
Holy shit, that felt good!
Yeah, I did kiss me! Oh, wow, Mary.
You still want me right here, right now.
More than anything.
Then you'll have to wait right here.
Where are you going?
We'll take a mattress, darling.
Open the ground, we'll do just fine.
I want this to be perfect.
Oh, no, wait, Mary, please.
Oh. Now get on the mattress. Oh, no, wait, get off.
That is what I am trying to do.
Linens, we need linens.
Are you completely nuts, Mary? We don't need
linens. I'm back, darling!
Oh, thank the gods.
Now get up and help me put the linens on the mattress.
Eryn, please, I am swelling so bad, I am gonna pop.
Oh, but we're just getting started.
Hurry, please hurry. This is not conducive to any other way. Finally.
Oh, silly!
What now?
A pillow. I forgot the pillow.
Fuck the pillow!
Oh, fuck that one, darling.
Get the pillow!
Second to last!
Ow!
I'm terribly sorry, baby. I wanted something soft for both your heads.
That, yes, sounds so nice.
Oh, darn it all!
What now?
Oils. I know how you like oils. I'll be right back.
You've got to be kidding me.
It'll only take a second.
So will this!
Such an epic prank to pull on my prick! Eryn!
Cinnamon.
together.
All I smell, sweetheart, is delay.
Delay? Do you smell delay now?
Nope, just a passing whiff.
What do you smell?
Peppermint!
Yes.
Have apple fig.
People don't appreciate their olfactory potential. They say that it's the most erotic of our senses. But most people underestimate the power of smell.
I appreciate it.
Oh, this is very serious, darling. You do need immediate attention. I guess I'm gonna have to play nurse for you, don't I?
Nurse, yes, the hot, hot, hot nurse.
It is getting hot out here, isn't it? Oh, a nurse can't work under such hot conditions. Oh, honey. Are you all right?
I don't know. I think I may need mouth to mouth.
Oh, you do, huh?
Oh, I do, yes.
Now, if I give you mouth to mouth, will you give me peace?
Whatever you want, I will give it to you.
I want a peace treaty.
Sure. Fine, whatever you want. But first, I want you.
What do you smell now, honey? Do you smell sex? Well, that's too bad, because all I smell is delay.
Wait, where are you going?
Sorry, honey, I'm just not in the mood to hump an unfaithful husband.
Unfaithful?
Yes, unfaithful. You're having a love affair with this war of yours.
A love affair?
Yes, she is who you are with when you're not with me.
Well.
She is who you snuggle up to and charm when you're not snuggling and charming me. She is who you go to whenever you leave me. And I won't take you back and I won't fuck you until you can assure me with a treaty that she is no longer in your life ever again.
Ah!
Give me a holler when you come back to be unsexed by your bloody mistress.
Ah! What? No, wait. Come back. Marry me.
This became a noise males were making all over the world.
Ah!
Which is how they came together to form a union.
Peace treaty?
Yes, please!
But if we sign a peace treaty, the women will have won!
So!
I just want as many hands on me!
And I would have it the sweet cherry tongue!
Oh, yeah, well, I want a pony! Made out of reruns of the Muppet Babies! And the Rugrats! And the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers! And the Magic School Bus! And Are You Afraid of the Dark? And even Stevens! And Lizzie McGuire! And now those fucking Nickelodeon and Disney Channel shows that I used to watch! And, of course, Thundercats!
Oh! If we don't sign a treaty, our wives won't quit. And we'll be fighting our battles both at home and abroad. Two enemies in one pissed off prick!
Several pissed off pricks!
Right, but if we do sign a treaty with Sparta, we run the risk of appearing weak, and thus susceptible to attack.
Are you kidding me? We are susceptible to attack regardless of which option we take. Please look at her.
No pun intended, but he's got a point. Last thing we need is for the Spartan army to see us in this condition.
Okay. I'm not done either.
Referred to as blue balls!
Now would be a good time to mention to all the non-believers that blue balls is a very real, very conflicting condition. Some people, namely men, have been known to suffer from it from time to time, despite its absence from the journals of any and all respectable medical authorities. Okay?
And what woman has done this to you?
We believe it was Lampedo who started it all. She led an uprising against the Spartan war efforts, seized our treasury, and left us men unsexed!
They may have suffered more than you can imagine.
No, I think we can imagine. Ours was led by one named Lysistrata. I'm a star. Such agony!
So I can see, sir. So I can see, sir, but you're not alone. Holy moly, it seems our growing pains have run its way as far as Sparta.
And what accord are you here, Sparta?
On an accord of peace.
We were just wondering what you'd say if we, well, you know, offered it.
They would say yes!
Stay out of this, little girl. Peace is a man's decision.
Then be a real man inside.
There are terms, Lysistrata, that must be discussed.
Then discuss them.
It is not as easy as you think.
Then I guess I'll just have to make things harder for you. Ladies!
Oh, my loving God, Linnaia! Tell Denise, my love!
This baby, I'm dying for your touch!
I'm the dog, I miss you so much.
I miss, honey. I miss the woman down here.
Irene, you have to understand, I had to. I'm a general.
I'm burning with desire, Hump Cake. I'm hot with passion.
What was that word, Phil?
Which one, Hump Cake or passion?
You call this passion?
What else would you call it?
Passion isn't fucking whenever you feel like it. Or fighting when it's fruitless. Passion is powerful, dominant, terrifying, universal. Take a look, soldiers. This is your wife. You go to bed with this person, and a miracle happens. You are able to see your human potential. Love. You can feel it in your bones when you look at it, don't you? It boils your marrow and cooks your blood until you're hot with it. And it moves you, taking you by surprise, and it tells you that what was once wrong is now right. What was once right is now wrong. And it destroys the autobiographical blueprints of your soul until its beams and supports come crashing down around you in a cloud of black smoke. And you are suddenly intestine free itself! This is passion. We ask for peace so that we can have a choice in how we live our lives. But how can we live them without you? We are better than this! All of us. So I ask you now, men, to sign a treaty for peace and embrace life.
Sir, what would you have us do, sir?
Sir! Sign the treaty! Oh,
hold on! Shannon, get on it! Go, stop!
I stopped your war, Athena. But I am not stopping with you. Aphrodite attacked my women. She and her son are next.
We need to talk.
Release the Kraken! What are you and your husband going to do on your first night back together?
What do you think?
Oh, God.
My point exactly, and I don't know about y'all, but I'm celebrating with sex!
Still, it's amazing though, huh?
Yeah, now we know it can be done. And what is done can always be undone.
Cupid, no! Run!
Don't fucking move!
Where is she?
No!
Where is she?
She's inside!
Bring her to me.
No.
Us. Your kind would be nothing more than a thought.
Fuck!
Flash in the pan!
Fate!
A magic trick! We are born and raised to understand life as fate! So that we can relax into the choices that we make. And then a god of war comes along and we are made to believe that we must play a part in it. When that happens, our choice belongs to a god and not to ourselves. And we lose our identity each time this happens. Each time. And it blinds us from seeing our potential. But today, we saw the tiniest part of it. Imagine what we will see tomorrow. A passion into the arrow's intention. Your friends here are dead because the arrows I used on them left them quitting life! Voila! It's that simple. But the arrow stuck in you, Lysistrata. Before I take your life, I want you to suffer. I want you to suffer in a way you've never suffered before. A suffering only the gods can know. It's like art, isn't it? You just point, aim, and project a passion into your intention. How does it feel, Lysistrata? How does it feel? Stay away from me, Athena!
Put your arrow down!
I don't understand this. We are gods! We're fucking gods! We built this place. We took nothing and created this!
And with that creation, arrow comes the responsibility.
Stay out of this, Herrera! This is my decision!
And I back it. 100%. You've turned, sweetheart.
I want to hear you say it, Herrera. I want to hear you say the words. Do you want me dead?
Yes, Cupid, we all do.
Gift, Cupid.
ensure the universe of the warmth and knowledge of love found and love lost. What is anything without balance? What is my passion without power? So you were forged by your father and I to control the wandering sheep, the apathetic, the blasphemers. You were our last line of defense until you became our first, and now our only.
Reconciliation, my dear.
remember this day, women, for it is the day the human being became divine.
Remember this day, men, for it is the day we finally opened our eyes.
Remember this day, my children.
The day our creations carried on.
Remember this day, all of you, for it is the day we built a ladder and climbed beyond the clouds, the moon, the sun, and the stars, and beyond the heavens.
We are blind.
Before you go home, have a great evening. You can stay here and have a better evening. Hey, Ben, I want to hear you sing.
All right.
Oklahoma home.
All right, okay, cool. As long as I can listen to you sing.
There's another, yeah, you got it. There's another sad song about the Oklahoma Dust Bowl. But I know why this one's sad.
I'm just going to give you back.
I'm still on your phone.
class last week.
What you got? You want a little hard times coming in, don't worry?
Yeah, over and over again. It just makes it like, this is the one.
Thank you.
Yeah.